Hello, I'm Mr. Onigiri, a lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist, and my father used to be a scientist too. He was a bachelor of science, and he did a lot of intuition or research into religion, and on Indian aspect, you know, he did a very deep research of his own through logical reasoning. Same method I have used, logical reasoning. I have discovered many, many things which the university professors who lack logical reasoning, they cannot know it. They haven't no knowledge of this thing. I call them super donkeys carrying holy books. If you ask them how many Jews died during the Holocaust, they will tell you 4 million, 5 million. But Jew is a spiritual self, not a physical self. Jew is never born, never died. So not a single Jew died, and not a single Sikh, Hindu or Muslim died in India, but the tribal people which were born and they died. This planet Earth is for the habitation of the tribal people in Adam. If you can build your covenant with Adam, then only you can live peacefully on this planet Earth. Otherwise you will kill each other, because you have no right to live on this planet Earth. I lived in Ghana for 14 years. Over there they have a tribal mark on their faces. By looking at the face of the person, you can tell he belonged to this tribe, that tribe, and so and so. But they lived like brothers. No fighting, nothing like that. In peace. So people who are in Africa and in Brazilian jungle, they have the tribal instinct. And remember that in Revelation, those who will be saved, 144,000, they are all mentioned by their tribes and not as Jews. So when you people become Jew of the physical self, of appearance, then they break their covenant with Abraham, who was ideal Adam, Sarah was Eve, and Yahweh gave them the promised land as the Garden of Eden. So they were the demonstration nation of the world, and we should learn lessons from them. So whenever they became unfaithful to Abraham, the same land became barren. And this carbon and all this nonsense doesn't make any sense, because people in Brazilian jungle, in African jungle, they have plenty to eat, and there's no floods or anything like that, no natural calamities over there. In Brazilian jungle, they live in huts, you know, made of straw. Strong wind doesn't come there, because Yahweh protects it. All these natural calamities are brought by Yahweh. Those who are unfaithful to Abraham are too unfaithful to their tribal fathers. So if you see this, the tribal instinct among the different countries, you will see that Russia has most of those states which are based upon tribes, Uzbekistan, Tajikistan, and so, all they are made of based upon tribal instinct, and the people have the tribal instinct. Over there, this Muslim Brotherhood tried to create problem in Chechnya, but the tribal people crushed it. And same in Morsi, because the Ishmael people, they worship Adam. Morsi tried to establish Muslim Brotherhood, and he became president, but the people locked that person in jail, and he died in jail. President Morsi was Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa. So are these Mullahs and other religious fanatics. because religion has no place on people to live on peace in Adam. You just need to be son of Adam, that's all. You don't need a religion. So sons of Adam, they have conscience and they will live in peace themselves. St. Thomas went to South India where they had tribal instinct and he preached gospel there. He was known as Christ Thomas, and so were his laborers known as Christ and not Christians, because they were preaching gospel from the core of their heart. The term here, the gospel gets written here, not in ink on paper. So this Bible is forbidden in the royal kingdom of God, where our covenant is of Holy Spirit and not of the dead letters. The covenant of dead letters finishes with John the Baptist, Luke 16 verse 16. And after that, Jesus opened the narrow gate to the royal kingdom of God, and those who are predestined, they left their families, everything, to enter that narrow gate. And those who enter that one, they have one Father, which is our supernatural Father of our soul, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. And they live like brethren. And that brotherhood had a love called agape, unconditional divine love, hating none. Moses created arrows in the wilderness, and there were no more rift among the brethren. And that is the snake was lifted up. So now is the end of the age. Because in the Bible, Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30, the present state is written there. When the end of the age come, I will bundle up the tares and burn them. Then I will ask the wheat plant to bring their fruit for my storeroom. So tares are those who are religious fanatics, who are Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Jew outwardly, and not of heart. They are the tares. And that's where these chosen people who are Jew outwardly and not of physical self. Physical self, they have to have established their covenant with Abraham. And that Abraham gave a tribal mark to Isaac, which is circumcision. But in the temple, they were malpractice. They were circumcising the Gentiles, slaves, and everyone. When they entered the fold of Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, oh, it was open to everyone. And so Stephen, the first caretaker of the Church of God headed by Christ Jesus, he was baptizing Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham. So those people, in the Stanic people who are Jew outwardly, they went to the high priest, Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa, Satan. And he called him to the Sanhedrin, and where Stephen, angel Stephen, he told them that our forefather Abraham was a noble man. And don't make fake sons of Abraham through circumcision for the sake of money, because chosen people are elite people. So many people wanted to join them. And these elite people, they are so stiff-necked or egoistic that they love to sit in the front part of the temple and the Gentiles were behind the wall. They were differentiating between Jew and Gentile. And that's why St. James he just told them that in God, Elohim, of our soul, there's no Jew or Gentile, no male or female. We're all sons of the Most High, we are equal. And the temple rabbis, they were not happy. So they planned next Passover. John says, St. James, just you go to the pinnacle and tell everyone what you are saying. He said, no problem. So at Passover, he went up on the pinnacle to tell everyone that in God we are equal. So be righteous. What the Jewish people were doing? The Jewish people, they were cheating the Gentile. And no Jew will be a witness to their cheating. Or the cheat, they have colluded together to build up their empire of Mammon. And that is where the Judah Iscariot, he won't cheat anyone. A poor man was sitting at the gate of a rich man. So riches are of Satan. Righteousness, poverty is of God. So today this Mammon and media is in the hand of the Jew outwardly, the sons of Satan. And they are in America. So America is Israel in disguise. So it protected them for 70 years, which is as the temple was destroyed in 70 AD. So after 70 years, there are only 5 years of conscience, of heart, the five husbands of the Samaritan woman. And then there will be atomic war. So in 2018, Trump, childlike Trump, pressed the tribulation button by declaring Jerusalem to be the capital of Israel. And that caused this Palestinian uprising and other things, you know. So the both Palestinian and the Jews, they are both unfaithful to Abraham. Abraham was not Hamas and all those nonsense. He was of Semitic race. Politics is of physical body, not of the spiritual. So, 5 years from 2018 will be the atomic war, which is on 14 May 2023, next year. Now, what Putin is doing? He is doing the same thing as Hitler and English did it. When in the England, the English were English, not conservative or labor parties. Political parties were English and Scotch and Irish. They killed Jews. Same way when the German became German, they killed Jews. And now Russia has the most tribal people. So Putin could be considered the same as Hitler. At that time when the English killed the Jewish people and Hitler killed the Jewish people, time of the Jews had not come. And now their time has come for disappear from the planet Earth. And this Putin has raised that sword against them. And this will be then, we bring the end to the atomic, end to the age through atomic war on 14 May 2023 when Israel is 75 years old. There are many more things I can tell, but if I tell everything, that this video will become over an hour, so it's not good. So just to say that, read New Testament, Matthew 13 verse 24 to 30. If you can understand it, then everything is written there about this atomic war. The Samaritan woman at the well, she had five spiritual husbands, not the physical husband. So people who have no spiritual knowledge, like the Oxford and Cambridge University professors, they call the Samaritan woman a prostitute, a bad one. Whereas the people in the Russian and other people, where they are tribal instinct, they know that she was St.Photina. They call her saint, and in the Cambridge and Oxford University, they call her a bad woman, a prostitute, marrying one husband after the other. Those five husbands are well known in India, among to the Sikhs. They are all spiritual, which are temptations of the heart. And this grace is of 5 years, from 2018 to 23. The 7 years, remember, these are 12 laborers. They have nothing to do with the 12 tribes. There were seven in the name of John the Baptist, of physical self, and five of heart, which is of spiritual self. So Jesus AD does not start when he was born, but when he was in his seventh year, then it started. That is the, if you see the menorah, the middle candle of the menorah is of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. He is the father of Christ. Whereas the other in Yahweh, this is in Yahweh, Christ is in my heart. No Christ in your heart, no gospel but dead letter you can study in the book. So people who have Christ in their heart, they are solitary themselves and they make other people solitary. So everyone has to give his own account to God. Nobody can give your account. So, seven is the one which is menorah. The middle candle, which is of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, Father of Christ, and mine also. Because in spiritual self, we have one Father. That's why Jesus said, no, don't call anyone on the earth Father. You have one Father, which is of your soul, Elohim, Allah, Abram. And that he is his will that's going on. Because he is the one who puts life into this pot. This is the pot created by Yahweh. That's why Jesus' name was Yeshua. Yeh from Yahweh, Shua or Shiva means the prime primordial Adam. The firstborn of Yahweh, the second Adam. Our Jesus was born of a virgin, Mary. He was anointed mustard seed. So, many things I can tell. So, I better leave it here, otherwise the video will be too big. If you are interested, watch my other videos and you will learn a lot. But in Christ Jesus, I am solitary. I make other people solitary. That was this. If you read John 4 carefully, when the Samaritan woman went to the village to tell them, to break the news of Christ Jesus, he said, I have found it, but don't believe me. Go and fetch him yourself, and you find it yourself. Nobody can find it for you, because you have to find it through logical reasoning, which you only have to do, not a third person. So this book knowledge is for everyone, but the power to do logical reasoning is gifted to a few, and they are called Christ and not Christian. So Christians are people of the book, and same in India, South India, the laborers of St. Thomas, they were not Christians. they were known as Christ. Portuguese Pope went there, no, only one Christ Jesus. You can't call yourself Christ. He burned their books and put them on stake. And they run away to jungles to hide themselves. That's what the Pope was doing. So we are very lucky to be alive and watching the end of the age and the atomic war. So preach the gospel and enter the fold of our supernatural Father, one fold, one shepherd. And then your life is saved. This may perish, my soul will be saved. It won't come into rebirth. In Christ Jesus we get resurrection, as Jesus demonstrated in Lazarus. Lazarus' family, they listened to Christ Jesus. And when he died, then Jesus, after 4 days, four are the scriptural states, after 4 days, he raised him up and bring him back. Then he told everyone what he saw over there. Because he went up, he knew what is up there. He sat in the lap of Abraham, because he was the son of, faithful son of Abraham. So, here you are. Our Father, God blesses you.